Hi friends, I am Dr. Deepak Namjoshi and today I am going to speak on a common lung disease which is known as COPD. COPD stands for chronic obstructive lung disease. This is a disease which affects the airways of the lungs. The lungs can be broadly divided into two parts. One, the airways which carry the air into the lungs, and the other, the alveoli, where the actual exchange of gases takes place, where oxygen crosses over to the other side into the blood to purify it, and the carbon dioxide crosses over from the impure blood into the lungs to be thrown out during your expiration. The disease which affects this process is called as COPD. It mainly encompasses two types of diseases, namely chronic bronchitis and emphysema. Chronic bronchitis is a disease which is characterized by damage to the airways, whereas emphysema is a disease which is characterized by damage to the alveoli. Both men and women suffer from COPD, but it has been found that perhaps in women the disease is more severe due to the reduced size of their lungs as well as perhaps of their airways. One of the common reasons why COPD occurs was initially thought to be smoking, but today we find that even non-smokers have COPD in them, which made doctors think that perhaps COPD is also caused because of exposure to air pollutants, to passive smoking. Even if you are not smoking and you are inhaling the smoke, that passive smoking also affects your lungs. Recurrent infections are known to damage your lungs and cause COPD. Especially if you have pneumonia, then pneumonia is known to have a permanent damage to the lung and can cause COPD. A few people have a genetic disorder due to which an enzyme called as alpha-1 antitrypsin is not manufactured enough in your body, due to which you develop COPD. But one of the foremost reasons still remains smoking. So smoking is one of the vital causes why COPD occurs. Now, what symptoms do you get in COPD? How do you understand that perhaps you may be having COPD? The commonest symptom is breathlessness, especially on activities which you were doing previously. Suddenly you start feeling that you are becoming breathless doing the same activity. You start feeling a tightness in your chest. People come back with recurrent cough and bringing out a sputum, which may be of different colors, which may be white, which may be green. It's commonly characterized by that. If you have emphysema, then even on doing basic activity, you start becoming very breathless, what we call as pink puffers. At times, certain people have a little bluish tinge to their lips and to their fingers, which will be because of advanced COPD, which leads to reduced oxygen levels in your body. If you get any of these symptoms, you consult a doctor. The doctor commonly does a very simple test called as PFT, or a lung function test, or a pulmonary function test, in which you blow into a machine. Based on how much you are able to blow into the machine, the volume of the air you are able to blow is measured, and it is compared. The machine has certain standards inside it, whereby a person of your age, height, weight normally should be able to blow how much air is already there in the instrument. It compares it with what you are performing and is then able to tell whether you are performing adequately or you are performing inadequately. Based on the level of inadequacy, you can diagnose whether you have COPD. One of the commonest diseases with which COPD is mistaken for is bronchial asthma. A bronchial asthma is again also a disease of the airway. The difference between the two is in COPD, you don't get too much of reversibility of the symptoms after taking your inhalers or any other medicines. Versus that, in asthma, you get complete respite from your symptoms when you take the inhalers or any other medicines. So commonly, you may be having asthma and may be thinking you are suffering from COPD, or vice versa, you may be having COPD and you will keep on thinking colloquially that you are having asthma. So doing the lung function test to distinguish between asthma and COPD is very important. In advanced stages of COPD, even a chest X-ray is able to identify whether you have COPD. There are various appearances of the lung on the X-ray chest, which guide you or guide doctors towards whether you have COPD. The third test which we commonly do is the CT scan of the chest, which is called as the HRCT chest. Again, on this imaging, there are certain features which are very characteristic of a person having COPD. So these three tests are commonly performed to find out whether you have COPD or not. There are many additional tests which help us to gauge the severity of COPD as well as to diagnose COPD. But I'm not going into all those details because those are more for doctors rather than for the layman. Now, what do you do once you get COPD? You may be getting COPD and it may be exacerbated because you have a chest infection at that time. So the chest infection requires antibiotics treatment and long-term bronchodilator treatment. As a preventive mechanism, what do? You stop smoking, or if you are being exposed to any kind of air pollution or toxic gases, you need to reduce that. How do you make your lungs strong? You do various kind of breathing exercises, the various forms of yogic exercises which help you in breathing, as well as a good physiotherapist will always show you various breathing exercises which strengthen your lungs and help to reduce the impact of COPD on your day-to-day life. Thank you, friends.